Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Easy Way to English. First of all, I wish you best of luck. I hope you have been learning for the competitive exam. Due to COVID-19, many children from private school have got admission in government school. Due to overcrowded admission, the government has decided to appoint many teachers. As per the proverb, make hay while the sun shines, make use of this golden opportunity. Keep learning regarding Shakespeare's plays. It's not only enough to learn the prescribed text, it is also essential to learn the quotes of Shakespeare. They have been asking so many quotes every year. So this video helps you enrich knowledge about Shakespeare's quotes. Let's get started. First one quote: the instrument of darkness tell us truth with honest trifles to betray sin deep consequence. This is about this quotation occurs in Macbeth. The instrument of darkness, Banquo utters these words to Macbeth. Banquo explains to Macbeth that sometimes agents of evil earn people's trust by telling the truth, which will lead to their self-destruction. Second one. Two truths are told. As happy prologues to the swelling act of the imperial though. This quotation takes place in the play Macbeth, Act 2, Scene 2, Scene 3. Macbeth refers to the first two truths told to him by the three witches. They hail Macbeth as Thane of Clamis and Thane of Cawdor. The witches who have prophetic powers makes a deep impression on Macbeth. He compares the truths to happy prologue leading up to imperial themes. Macbeth is here talking to himself. Here he reveals his ambition. Third one. Your face, my Thane, is as a book where men may read strange matters. This quotation occurs in Macbeth. Lady Macbeth utters these words to Macbeth. Lady Macbeth compares Macbeth's face to that of a book that man can read. She does not want other lords to recognize Macbeth's true intentions. She encourages him to appear normal. To begin the time, look like the time. Bear welcome in your eye, your hand, your tongue, look like the innocent flower. This quote occurs in Macbeth. This quotation is uttered by Lady Macbeth. She said, Macbeth should deceive Duncan and his court by acting like a smiling, welcoming host. Despite his black desires, he must appear like the innocent flower. That memory, the wonder of the brain, shall be a fume, and the receipt of reason, a limbic only. This quote occurs in Act 2, Scene 2 in Macbeth. Lady Macbeth utters this quotation. She has succeeded in making King Duncan's chamber drunken. She has drugged their drinks. She refers here to the gods. Here is a farmer that hanged himself. Search for it. This quotation takes place in Macbeth. Macbeth is like the farmer who tried to take a shortcut to achieve goal. This quotation is uttered by Porter. Rather than depend on hard work to get ahead, Macbeth tries to shorten the road to royalty by killing Duncan, farmer who had headed his crops to sell at inflated prices during the next famine. There is nothing serious in mortality. All is but choice. Renown and grace is dead. The wine of life is drawn. This quotation occurs in Macbeth. Macbeth said these words. He would have been happy if he had died before Duncan to convey that life without the king is not worth living. This expression is insincere and exaggerated. Here he hides his true feelings. Had I not four or five women once that tended me? This quote occurs in Tempest, Act 1, Scene 1. Miranda said these words. Temperance was a delicate wench. This quotation is acquired by Antonio in Tempest, Act 1, Scene 1. I think he will carry this island home in his packet and give it to his son for an apple. This quotation occurs in Tempest. Sebastian utters these words about Gonzalo. Gonzalo is a miracle. He will even carry island home in his packet and give it to his son. My Lord Sebastian, the truth you speak doth lack some gentleness and time to speak in. Here, Gonzalo said these words in Tempest. Gonzalo gently tells Sebastian, this is not the time, for I told you he is rubbing salt in wound when he should be offering a band-aid. That means he is putting fire in his words. That is, what a strange drowsiness. What a strange drowsiness possesses them. Sebastian in Tempest. I remember you did supplant. I remember you did supplant your brother Prospero. The speech is said by Sebastian. Sebastian is suggesting that Antonio overthrew his brother, so maybe he could do it too. It has got two meanings. Excellent falsehood. Why did he marry Fulvia and not love her? This quotation occurs in Antony and Cleopatra, Act 1, Scene 1. This is uttered by Cleopatra. It's a soliloquy. My precious queen, forbear and give true evidence to his love, which stands an honorable deal. This quotation occurs in Antony and Cleopatra. Antony said these words to Cleopatra. That I might sleep out this great gap of time. Act 1, Scene 5. Cleopatra utters these words in Antony and Cleopatra. Welcomes to Rome. Caesar utters these words in Antony and Cleopatra. My salad says, when I was in green in judgment, cold in blood. Here, Act 1, Cleopatra utters these words. Salad days refers to days of carefree innocence and pleasure of our youth. Cleopatra is regretting her youthful dalliances with Julius Caesar. It has got two meanings. Salad, is this a sort of meal? One was once in less lavish. If the great goddess be just, they shall assist the deeds of justest men. Pompey in Antony and Cleopatra. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this video helps you enrich the knowledge of Shakespeare's code. Thank you so much. Please subscribe.